Hello friends, welcome back to Quick Glance videos. Today we will discuss again the second part of the asexual vegetative reproduction video. First part we had discussed, and this is second part where we will be covering some part of the asexual reproduction mode. Again, coming to the features of asexual reproduction, it's created by a single organism, offspring created by a single organism. They produce nearly exact copy of itself. The genetic identity is there, and it is used for rapid multiplication of the organism. The vegetative parts which reproduce have primary and secondary meristems, which are capable of active cell divisions. These are some features by which the asexual reproduction takes place in plants. Now, in the previous video, we have covered bulbs, tunicated bulbs, imbricate, comb, tuber, stem tuber and root. In this video, we will be covering the runners, adventitious roots, suckers, stolon, rhizome and plantlets with some examples so that in briefly you can understand and you can understand the brief of that particular mode of reproduction and the examples. Runners. Some plants have long stem that grows along the soil surface. They have buds on them. So it is a long stem and it has buds on them. So adventitious roots appear at the nodes. So if there are nodes, the adventitious roots appears and the buds which are located there, they comes out as a shoot. So adventitious roots appear at the nodes where the buds are located. When the nodes touch the soil, the new shoots begin to grow into new plants. The runner continues to grow as a stem and keeps running. And so the new plants keep on coming from the nodes and the propagation takes place. We have the example for this strawberry, Bermuda grass and peppermint. So you can see the runner near the soil surface, a node is there, the root stems and a shoot comes up. So that's how this is a mint. So this the propagation takes place like this. Next is the adventitious roots. When the adventitious roots appear in any plant part which is used for vegetative reproduction like stem or leaves. Adventitious roots can appear any part of the plant. Now there are two modes of the adventitious roots which comes. Either it is comes under normal condition and a normal development like crown roots in the cereals or nodal roots on strawberry. It's a normal way of coming, or in response to certain stress condition. This is very important. In response to certain stress condition like flood or nutrient deprivation or wounding, under this stress condition the adventitious roots comes out and helps the plant to propagate. For example, the poison ivy has roots, and this is a way from the leaves it's coming out, from the cereal nodes it's coming out. So this is an example for adventitious roots. Suckers, which is also called root sprouts. Suckers are a plant stem that arises from the buds on the base plant or the stem or root. Suckers may also sprout from the bud near the base of the parent plant and can grow into a new plant. Most of the shrubs, trees propagate through suckers. So for example, for suckers are like banana, apple tree, cherry tree, banana. They are the common examples where from the base of the plant the new plant comes out from the soil surface. In case of rose, you must have seen small suckers coming out from the base of the plant. Stolon or runners, the difference between stolon and runners is very little. Stolon or the runners are horizontal oriented stem that grows along the soil surface. It first grows obliquely upwards and then bends down to touch the ground surface. So it grows up from the base and goes parallel to the soil surface. So that's how the stolon goes. Stolon is a shoot that grows along the ground and produces roots at the nodes. So it goes parallel to the ground and produces roots at the nodes. Whereas runners is a long stolon. It's a long stolon sent out by the plant in order to root new plantlets. It's a long stolon. So the same as stolon, but it's a longer form. This is an example of stolon. Silverweed hawkweed, strawberry. So you have a shoot coming out, stem coming out like this, parallelly going to ground, roots coming, buds coming up. So these are the example for stolon. Rhizome. Rhizomes are stem-like structure that grow horizontally across the ground, which forms root and shoot from the nodes. Rhizomes may also show nodes and internodes along the length and sends out roots and new shoots from the nodes. Rhizomes grow below the ground and hence often called as underground. Now, this grows horizontally parallel to the surface of the soil. So, you have a rhizome, it will go horizontally like this. It will have internodes. From internodes, the new plant and the roots comes out. So, we have a common example of ginger, turmeric, fern. So, these are the and there is a nodes there, and from here the plants, new plant will come out and the roots, adventitious roots in the base of that. Plantlets, miniature structure that arise from the meristem of the leaf margin that eventually develops into roots and drops off from the leaves they grew on. So like in the case of bryophyllum, this is the most common example. It's also the mother of thousand or irrigator plant, where at the margin of the leaf the plant comes out, roots also develops here and it eventually falls down. So you can see in the picture, this falls down and develops into a new individual. So these are the plantlets mode of vegetative reproduction. So we have in both the videos, we have almost covered all the types of vegetative reproduction with brief and some example which you can remember for exam and easily write any answer which is coming related to this. It's not a detailed explanation but a brief explanation so that you can remember the basic things. These are three questions, quick glance questions. What is vegetative reproduction? How vegetative reproduction takes place in ginger? What under what condition the adventitious roots initiate? You can answer these questions in the comment area and keep watching quick glance videos for more topics to come. Thank you.